Goldis, he is the chief medical officer for Kern Medical. He is here to talk more about the vaccines and the latest on the coronavirus pandemic here in Kern County. Dr. Goldis, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Let's just first talk about the AstraZeneca vaccine. Some good news here, but there's also a lot of attention on this vaccine. If it does get approved next month, it would become the fourth vaccine to be distributed here in the United States. What does this all mean for us?
Well, as you mentioned, in their phase three trials, it was extremely effective, 79% effective overall and 100% in stopping severe and fatal disease. But more interestingly, no increased risk of thrombosis or clot among the 21,000 individuals who received at least one dose. And this is overriding concerns that were prominent in Europe last week. And it's over 80% effective in those over 65 years of age. However, this morning, the National Institute of Allergies and Infectious Diseases stated that AstraZeneca may actually have relied on some outdated information, leading to what they're calling an incomplete view of efficacy. So the company will need to go back and re-examine the statistics that they reported, and we'll have to wait and see if, in fact, that changes the overall efficacy reported.
Do you think it's even going to be necessary to have a fourth vaccine being distributed or administered here in the United States? I mean, considering that we already have three, Johnson & Johnson was just approved just a couple of weeks ago. That's the one dose vaccine. That was the latest to get approved, and that's being administered across the nation. And then on top of that, we already have the Moderna and Pfizer vaccines. So, I mean, do you think we're going to get to the point where we're going to need this fourth vaccine? Do you think it's essential?
I do. I mean, we're still on allocation with regard to who gets a vaccine in certain numbers at any given time. And the reality is that still only about 25% of the total U.S. population has received at least one dose of a vaccine. So we still have a long ways to go. And in my view, more vaccine means more availability and less reliance on this allocation model.
Okay, I want to talk about the variants. So this is actually kind of a great segue here because when there is... You, again, have talked about this before. It is the race to vaccinate people before these variants start to take hold here across the country, but here in our community especially. And we now know that the B117 strain was detected in Kern County last week. So we already know that other strains of coronavirus are spreading in Kern County. How concerning, though, is this for you as a medical professional, considering that we just came down from this winter surge? Our numbers are some of the best that we've seen in literally months and could soon be the best that we've seen in more than a year. And yet there's still kind of that warning that these variants could be spreading. What do we need to be looking at when we're talking about these variants and the future of how we live our lives and getting closer to normalcy?
Yeah, there's this lingering concern about the variants and the effect they will have on the overall numbers. We, in fact, have seen now this first case of UK variant a few days ago, as you mentioned. There's actually 470 cases of this variant in California so far that we know of, and over 6,300 reported cases of the UK variant in the US. This variant is 50% more transmissible, and there's a likelihood that it actually is more deadly and causes more severe illness, which is very worrisome. And so the good news, of course, the vaccines themselves appear to be just as effective against the variant as the regular coronavirus. But I am especially concerned about not just this variant, but what they're calling the West Coast strains, two other variants that in combination have caused almost 8,000 cases in California. And so compared to the 471 of the UK, it's really quite dramatic. So vaccines versus variants, it's all about getting vaccinated ahead of these variants as soon as possible. Otherwise, we may not see these numbers continue to decline.
All right, Dr. Goldis, once again, talking about the latest on the vaccines, you said before, it truly is a race to get people vaccinated before these variants start to really take hold. Thanks so much for joining us this morning. Do appreciate it. We'll see you on Thursday.
Thank you.